What's up, YouTube? My name's Cooper, and welcome to the new series for Champion Gamer Network. Me and Sean both apologize for not uploading in over a year. With me being in college and him also in college doing separate things, we decided to come back and do our channel. We're going to do separate series, I feel like, as long as we're also going to be doing COD 4 game battle videos, because that's coming up. It actually came back after a year and a half of being down, so if you guys would enjoy that, leave it in the comments. But also, what I'm going to be doing right now is be a GM mode for NHL 14. Sorry, I'm really sick right now, and I'm just trying to get fluid in me. But GM mode, I'm probably pretty much late on the party joining it, but I really love doing this, and hopefully I can continue on when NHL 15 comes out. So if you guys would like that, leave a like and a comment. I'm going to need help, because I'm not that great at GM mode as of now. I'm good at the first couple of years, but then the third or fourth year, I just start declining, so I'm going to need some help. So I'm gonna, if you have any ideas for trades or players we should get, let me know. So anyways, getting on to this, trade difficulty, we're going to play on hard, because I like hard, because it's much more of a challenge. Waivers are going to be off. I never play with waivers. Starting roster's current. Now, I edit the roster for my team a little bit, getting some players a little bit better than they should be, but a little bit worse some other players. Just try to balance it out, like what they are actually in the NHL nowadays. Salary cap, we're going to play on, of course. We're not going to play with authentic cap penalties. I think that's stupid. Fantasy draft is definitely off. Auto sign free agents, no. Rules, we can't do injuries there. But assistant coach edit lines, we're going to say no on that. Trade offer notification, yeah. Alright. So, I had a huge thought. Oops. Did not mean to click the Bruins. Let me edit my name real quick. Cooper. But I had a huge, like, who I should pick to be my team. But, I'm just going to play a GM skill medium. I had a huge, like, who I should choose. I was, like, really thinking between Buffalo, Calgary, Hurricanes, or, I think it was, yeah, Edmonton. But then I realized there's one other team, and I really never see people do a team like this, because, and also because, they just got a pretty good draft. New GM, new coach, I think. Changed the name of where they are. I'm trying to hint at it. But I think they have one of the best drafts this year. They're really an underdog this year. So I feel like I am going to be doing the Phoenix Coyotes, a.k.a. the Arizona Coyotes. Now, I'll show you some people that I actually made a little better, or made their overall better, and I also made down better. Like, for example, Mike Smith, the goalie, I made him worse than he actually is, because he is not that great of a goalie in real life. He was an 88 in this game and an elite goalie. I can't see that. I made him down to an 85, and he's just a normal starter. I can't see any better than that. There's my real Coyotes game. I think I'm just going to save over it. That one, I had a lot of players. For some reason, I ended up having, like, 4 first-round draft picks first 2 years. So I got Connor McDavid and Clark, Brett Clark, and all that. But, so anyways, we are going to be showing our team right now. I'm going to need help who I should get, everybody. So, let's see who our team is right now. So we have Korpikov, never heard of him. Anyways, he's a left wing, 82 overall. We have Vermint. We have Bodecker. Oh wow, Bodecker's a red star, 4 red star. Alright, I can work with that. Mike Rubio. Alright, so I want Mike Rubio definitely playing center. Now Vibrata. How did he do this year, last year? I don't care about playoff. 34 games played, 28 points? Dude, you're definitely going up to the front line. And Bo Decker can go right here. Moss can go there. So then that. Oh wait, Irit. Oh crap. Hansel should play. Yeah. And then we have a power forward, a two-way forward, and another two-way forward. That'll be our second defenseman line. We have Vibrata, Rubio, Joan, Korpikoski, Vermen, and Moss. Vermen, oh my god. He's only a 31, 3.5 star. So he's not getting better. What about Korpikoski? See, I've never played with this guy before. Lori Korpikoski, I don't even know how to say his name. Korpikoski? If you guys know how to say his name, please tell me. I'm sorry if I butcher it. So let's see. Yandel, Morris. See, no. I need to get rid of Schlumko. Alright, let's see what we got here. Alright, we're just going to go to the worst players and bring them down to the minors. Minors. Clint Cammer, you're going to the minors. Yeah, Gormley. See, I made Gormley a little better, so he deserves to be on this team. Let's see, who else do we got? Defenseman. Who's going to be our defenseman this year? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Schlemko, you go down. Alright. So that's going to be a good top 6. We are going to have Ekman, Larson, Yandel, Mikulek, Moritz, Stone, and then Gormley. I made Stone a little better. I don't think I made his overall better, but maybe, I think he was, Yeah. He was just a 3.5 green. I just made him to a 4 green. He deserves way better, because he had an amazing season this year, I feel like. And I'm not even a Arizona Coyote fan. I am a Bruins fan. And I think we had the worst draft possible as of now. Not the worst draft. I think we drafted pretty well. But I think we had the worst, free agent so far. We didn't pick up anybody. We didn't get a Jerome Ginla back, which I'm really mad about. So, oh crap. We had to edit lines. What line? I think the best line's Portland. I don't really care about my AHL. Oh wait. No, Shane Doan deserves to be a... Yeah. And Korpikoski, yeah, alright. Now I was gonna make sure some of these players are supposed to be playing. Shane Doan's a second, but he's gonna be playing first. Alright, so Rubio, you deserve that. Hansel second, Irez a second, Bodecker's a second. Vermette is a third, alright. Third. Alright, just making sure. 4-4-4. Can any of these guys fight? Fighting skill 83. Fighting skill 7. Wait. Is he a 4? Yeah. Alright. First things first, we are going to be signing a center for the fourth line that can replace, what is his name? That rookie I just had up. He deserves to be one more year down in the minors so we can get really good before I bring him up. Because fourth line, you're not going to see any lot of moves. And, I want him to progress faster than possible. So, here's our, you know, free agents list. Now, we could go, like, for a guy like Saku Koivu. Let him retire as a Coyote? I have no idea. But he doesn't have a good fighting skill, but he has a good... Nothing, never mind. But anyways, so what we're going to do here is we're going to go all the way over to... let's see, where is it? Fighting skill? Yeah, fighting skill. So now, George Parros is always going to be the first overall. He has really good fighting skill, but he does not have good discipline. And what I've noticed, the best discipline and good fighting is Jared Smithson. and he ends up being a really good player for Maine. So we're gonna do 3 years. How about 8.6? Yeah, let's do 8.6 for Jared Smithson. So what we're also gonna be doing, guys, is contracts. Now there's one player we haven't signed yet who's supposed to be really good, and it's Laurent Dauphin. Now, Laurent Dauphin, we haven't signed him yet, but he's supposed to be a 3.5 green, which is not bad. We gotta figure out how to sign him, but we have too many players, so we're gonna have to get rid of someone right now, and we gotta get rid of someone for Smithson right now. So what I'm thinking about doing is doing a trade right now. Now, I want you guys to let me know if I should trade or not. So what I'm thinking about is, well, Anaheim has an Ottawa, and now Ottawa's pick does not go up like Anaheim's. Ottawa's first round draft pick has like pretty much no trade value, so I could definitely trade for that and have a free first round draft pick for a nobody. Or it's Vancouver. Now Vancouver does not have a good first round draft pick, and they are always terrible their first year. Now I haven't updated the rosters fully because there hasn't been an update yet, so they don't have Ryan Miller. They have Markstrom. So if we could do that, that would be amazing. So I was thinking about getting rid of, like, who's Burke? Whoa, who's this Burke kid? Brendan Burke. Never heard of him. Yeah, see, we could get rid of Brendan Burke or something. Vincent. Ooh, wow. Did not even know he was in our farm system. 4.5 gold? Oh, wow. All right. So we're definitely keeping him. He's our future. So we could get rid of Burke for Vancouver's first and someone else, actually. We could get, like, an Eddie Lack or a Markstrom. Eddie Lack would be a good backup to have for Mike Smith. Let's see who else we got. Anyone with trade value? Any rookie staters? Ooh, wow. Shinkakurt. Shinkaruk. Shinkaruk. I think that's his name. Shinkaruk. Jay Subban? Oh, whoa. Is this... Oh, this is Malcolm Subban and PK Subban's brother, I think. Discipline's an 80. Ooh, that's not bad at all. Offensive defenseman. Ooh, see, that would be amazing if I got, like, all the Subban brothers on one team. We'll think about that later. So, what I could get from them is pretty much nothing as of now. Let's see, all skaters. Potential. Who has really low potential? Or high potential, but low. Matthias. Yeah. Zach Dolpe. Yeah, Zach Dolpe. He got 13 points in 16 games in the AHL, but that's AHL. Wow, that was playoff stats. 42 points in AHL. Oh, wow, he's been in there for a long time. 57 points in 61 games. 4 points in 15 NHL games. I don't think he's ready for the NHL, so I don't think we're going to do that right now. We could go for a Jordan Subban. So if you guys want a Jordan Subban, we could do Burke for a first round and Jordan Subban. That will definitely go through as it is. We could also add another player if you want, or we add another player. But also, what I'm going to be doing right now... Sorry, I should have just twitched teams. We are going to trade Tampa Bay for someone. Now, why Tampa Bay, you ask? They have nobody, right? Wrong. They have someone... Adam Erne, no trade value whatsoever. But look at that, 4.5 red. And he was a really good, ends up being a really good third line.
or second line, depending on your team. So I feel like we're going to go for Adam Erne. Now, let's see. So he has no points. He hasn't been playing. This is his first year ever. He's going to be in the CHL. So we're gonna have a while for him, a.k.a. 1 year. So let's see. Let's see our highest trade value. So it's going to be Gormley, of course, and Lesio, Dauphin, Domi, Stone, Ekman-Larsson. End up getting rid of Ekman-Larsson a while ago. He's good, but that cap of 5.5 really needed off. So let's see who we got here, who we can get rid of. My bad. Let's see just rookie goal. Or, yeah. What about... Yeah, I don't think they can take a lot of players. So can we do, like... Yeah, Plente and... Did that go through? Let's try it. We consider taking Lamponte if you want to try him. Oh, forget that. I'm not getting rid of him. What did Samuelson? Oh, no. He ends up getting really good for me for some reason. He's not going anywhere. Alright. How about a goalie? Do you guys want a goalie? How about a Langhammer? Langhammer, Dostoevsky, and Lapplant. Never heard of him for Erne. Okay, so they want Lapplant, but they don't want... Alright, how about get rid of him for Mike Lee? And then get rid of Mike Lee. And then be like... Alright, we need some more players. How about a draft pick? Let's see, this guy really ends up being worth it, guys. So I'm gonna give him a, how about a New Jersey 7th? Alright, how about a 6th? Alright, how about a 5th? Okay, I don't really want to go to the 3rds yet. Alright, how about we get rid of the 5th? Get rid of all that. Alright, so Erne. What else do they have? See, we could get a 2nd. Or we could get a 3rd. Tampa Bay 3rd. Ooh, Tampa Bay 3rd would sound really nice, because 3rd round draft picks this year will be really good for us. Let's see. Don't want to get Doan away yet. I think we're going to be a playoff team anyway this year. Let's see, who is this Korpikoski guy? He's a 3.5, 27-year-old. See, I basically just should get rid of Doan then, but... Because Erne will just replace him. What's his overall? He's a 6. Yeah, if I give it a year. Yeah, I think I'm going to get rid of that left wing we have of Korpikoski. For that would definitely go through. Now, let's see if it will go through if we actually do a 2nd instead of a 3rd. Alright, how about the New York Rangers 2nd? Alright, so how about a 3rd? Wow, they don't even want a 3rd. That... No, I need a draft pick from this. This is not fair. I need a 3rd. I'll give you something else then. How's that? I'll give you a 7th. That seems really fair, to be honest. And it doesn't mean our trade block very well. Alright, how about if I give you $5 million? Alright, that is not... okay. How about 2 7th round picks? Oh my god, alright. I mean, I guess I could just do it straight up. I don't even know how to say his fucking name. Korpikoski, because I'm never going to say it again after I get Adam Erne. Will it go through? Yes, it is. If I did accept this off... of yours, the Tampa Bay Lightning fans will call my resignation. This is a no-brainer to say yes to. Yeah, screw you too, man.
Let's see. Now, there's one more rookie I kind of want to grab. Now, I don't remember at all, like, what team he's on, but he's a really low rookie. He's really good. I mean, I could always just go to here and get... Ooh, Drake Gardner's thing went up a little bit, actually. Let's see, what team would he be on? He has a low trade value as a good potential. I have no idea what team he's on, though. Yeah, Alex Ovechkin, hate you so much. Oh, we're here. He's a right wing. Kuntsov. He's a 4.5 red. He's an 80 overall at the age of 21. He was drafted in the first year, but he has no trade value, which will be really nice. He could play that third line and replace, he could replace, what's his name, the guy we just got rid of, Kuprikov. Yeah, I think we're going to go for Kunitskov. Yeah, third line, yeah, alright. So, let's see what we can get rid of for him. Now, we can get rid of Gormley. We can definitely get rid of Gormley. So we can get rid of Chipchura, Halpern. See, I can get rid of Halpern because he's old. And then we're going to get rid of... We could get rid of Schlemko. He's a 26-year-old. He's not getting any better, in my opinion. Alright, that's never going to go through. We're going to need someone with just a little bit of trade value. We can get rid of Moss. Alright, how about... No, Burke. Wait. Oh, yeah, never mind. That trade never went through. I can't get rid of Burke yet. We can get rid of Dauphin. Dauphin does not actually get that good. But I'd rather keep Dauphin just right now because I don't think they would do it. Adam Erne, we're not getting rid of. We just got him. Who's C. Murphy? Crap. Alright. C. Murphy. Nope, Connor Murphy's a red star. I'm going to keep him. Get rid of Mike Smith. No. See, I can bring Schlemko up for a year and get rid of... Ooh. How about that? Oh, the league won't approve it because of the cap. When are you going to approve it because of the cap? Alright. I think we could wait a year and get it. So I feel like that would be a good trade. So we need to get that going through. What players do they want to get rid of? This guy is their highest. Nope, see, that won't work. I don't want a freaking Holtby. I can go for Halleck. No, I don't want Halleck. I'm just gonna wait on that right now. Because we can go get our, lines back anyways. So, edit lines. So, oops. What's my wrong line? Oh, alright. Halpern's going right there. See who we got we can bring up. Yeah, oh, wow, yeah, we can bring Paul Bissonnette up. That'll be an enforcer. Yeah, that'll be a decent line. Vermeent, Halpern, and Moss, for Bissonnette, Chipura, and McMillan. Until that whole thing, fiasco, hurries up. So what we're going to do is we're going to sim up to the first day. my GM rep is dropped. Oh, look at it, I'm a rookie GM. What we're going to do is we're going to... Oh, we can't even bring it up into Amateur Scout yet. We already have that up. So if I sim up, we should have... Yeah, there we go. Now we have the updated salary cap. So now I can trade with Washington. And we're going to trade for... what's his name? Don't even... Kirpikov? Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov, yeah! Alright, it's Gator matching the block. Yes, you definitely need, Derek Morris. See, now it'll go through. Let's see if we can get something else from him, actually. Maybe a draft pick? I'm pushing it here with a draft pick, but... Oh, wow, alright. So we got Kuznetsov and a second round draft pick for Morris. So let's go to roster moves. Alright. Hey, Schlemko, guess what? You're coming up, big boy. Clint Cameron, you're going to stay down for one more year. You're not that great yet. Yeah, defense. We're going to put Goro, what's his name? Not Kuznetsov, Schlemko. I'm going to edit all this too, guys. Schlemko. It's not going to be Schlemko. I'm just going to put Schlemko in right now. And we're going to see what we can do. Yeah, because Ormley deserves to be not with Schlemko. He is so much better than anything like that. Alright, so what we're going to do now is going to get rid of Paul Bissonnette. And we're going to replace in all lines of Kuznetsov. And then we're going to bring Kuznetsov up to the left wing. Actually, we're going to bring him up to the right wing where he deserves... Yeah. Two-way forwards and a playmaker. I don't know if that'll work together, but we'll see. If not, we can always just bring him up and get rid of... Put Hansel... No, oh, that'll be 3-2-way forwards. Yeah, we can bring Hansel down, put Kuznetsov up to the center for the second line. It says we have 19 people. Oh, Bissonnette. I gotta scratch him. Alright, so that's our offensive line, it looks like. If you guys have any suggestions who I should move, leave it down in the comments. Let's see, we got defense now. We got Ekman Larson, Yandel, Stone, Mikulek, Schlemko, and Gormley. I don't think... I'm going to keep Yandel on the first line, but we're going to put Stone on the front line with him. Because I'd rather have a two-way defenseman, an offensive defenseman, an offensive defenseman, a defensive defenseman, and then a two-way and a two-way together. I'd rather not have two offensive, because that could lead up goals. I don't want that to happen. So first power play is going to be Vibrata, Rubio, Erat, Gormley, and Yandel. Yes, I agree with that completely. Then it'll be Bodecker, Hansel, and Dome. Yeah. We're just gonna... Yeah, that'll be fine. Four-man power play will be Rubio, Vibrata, Yandel, and Gormley. Yep. Penalty kill will be Mikulek, Schlemko, Halpern, and Vermeent. Yes, this is does not make sense. Yandel does not need to be on the penalty kill. Stone. It should be Stone and Gormley. Let's do Stone and Gormley. Yeah, that'll work. Three-man PK will be Halpern, Mikulek, Schlemko. Yeah, let's just move Ekman Larson down there for the three-man PK. Four on four lines will be Ekman Larson, Yandel, Mikulek, Stone. I don't want Mikulek in there. I'd rather have Gormley in there for 4-on-4, because he's not that bad. Then Schlemko, Gormley, so this will be, wasn't Ekman Larson I took out. Is it Mikulek? Yeah, it's Mikulek. So it'll be Mikulek, Schlemko. Extra attacker, we have Rubio and Riandel. Yeah, that sounds right. And then we have Mike Smith and Thomas Greis. Alright, that looks like a pretty good line. So, yeah. So guys, this has been the first episode of NHL GM mode for the Arizona Coyotes. This has been Cooper, and if you guys want me to continue the series, tell me down below. And yeah, All right, I will see you guys later. Have a good day.